In 1989, I took a big challenge. It was to read my Bible every single day, zero excuse. I figured this, if I go to bed every day, if I wake up every day, if I go to the bathroom every day, eat every day, brush my teeth every day, well, mostly, and floss every day, 4 out of 5 dentists recommend that, that I could read my Bible every single day, zero excuse. September 1989, I took the challenge. Well, it's been 30 years. Last night, I continued reading, and I haven't missed one day in 30 years. Nearly 10,700 some odd days reading the Bible straight. Has it made a difference? I still have my issues. I still have my own struggles. People things, personality things, life things. But I can say that reading the Bible has made a huge impact on my personal life, on my relationship with God and other people, and just how I fare in life. Here's what I want to challenge you with. I see no excuse why you can't read the Bible every single day. I hear these kind of things. I just didn't have time. I don't do it. I forgot. I meant to. I feel so guilty. Or I just don't understand it. I tried. I get nothing out of it. I mean, there are a lot of excuses why we can't. But it's so easy now to read it every day with all the apps and all of the versions. I want to challenge you to do it. What excuse do you think is worthy not to read the Bible every single day? I really can't find any myself. And I want to challenge you to jump on with me and begin to read it every single day. So a few months ago, as I was just thinking about my life, the future of what I want to spend my energy doing, I really felt in my heart, I want to inspire people to fall in love with God's Word. I want to inspire people to become Bible reading experts, just reading it, nothing else other than just to make it part of your daily habit. So I thought, what better way to start off a Monday than just reading Ephesians chapter 5, one chapter out of the Bible. We took a big challenge yesterday at Believers Church that all of us in Believers Church would read Ephesians 5 Monday through Saturday, every single day this week, and then come back Sunday and see how much God has been speaking to us as a group of believers who are learning to fall in love with God's Word again. And so I'm going to do that. I'm going to read Ephesians 5, and I want to ask you, what verse sticks out to you? And then just drop me a message, put it on there and say, man, this speaks to me. Let me know what the Lord is talking to you about. Here we go, Ephesians 5, join in with me. I use the New Living Translation, verse 1. Here we go. Imitate God, therefore, in everything you do, because you are His dear children. Live a life filled with love, following the example of Christ. He loved us and offered Himself as a sacrifice for us, a pleasing aroma to God. Let there be no sexual immorality, impurity, or greed among you. Such sins have no place among God's people. Obscene stories, foolish talk, and coarse jokes, these are not for you. Instead, let there be thankfulness to God. You can be sure that no immoral, impure, or greedy person will inherit the kingdom of Christ and of God. For a greedy person is an idolater, worshiping the things of this world. Don't be fooled by those who try to excuse these sins, for the anger of God will fall on all who disobey Him. Don't participate in the things these people do, for once you were full of darkness, but now you have light from the Lord. So live as people of the light, for this light within you produces only what is good and right and true. Carefully determine what pleases the Lord. Take no part in the worthless deeds of evil and darkness. Instead, expose them. It is shameful even to talk about the things that ungodly people do in secret. But their evil intentions will be exposed when the light shines on them, for the light makes everything visible. This is why it is said, awake, O sleeper, rise from the dead. Christ will give you light. So be careful how you live. Don't live like fools, but like those who are wise. Make the most of every opportunity in these evil days. Don't act thoughtlessly, but understand what the Lord wants you to do. Don't be drunk with wine, because that will ruin your life. Instead, be filled with the Holy Spirit, singing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs among yourselves, and making music to the Lord in your heart, and give thanks for everything to God the Father in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And further, submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. For wives, this means submit to your husbands as to the Lord. For a husband is the head of his wife, as Christ is the head of the church. He's the Savior of his body, the church. As a church submits to Christ, so you wives should submit to your husbands in everything. For husbands, this means love your wives, just as Christ loved the church. He gave up his life for her to make her holy and clean, washed by the cleansing of God's word. He did this to present her to himself as a glorious church without spot or wrinkle or any other blemish. Instead, she will be holy and without fault. In the same way, husbands ought to love their wives as they love their own bodies. For a man who loves his wife actually shows love for himself. No one hates his own body, but feeds and cares for it just as Christ cares for the church. And we are members of his body. As the scriptures say, a man leaves his father and mother and is joined to his wife, and the two are united as one. This is a great mystery, but it is an illustration of the way Christ and the church are one. So again, I say, each man must love his wife as he loves himself, and the wife must respect her husband. Ephesians 5. I challenge you to read Ephesians 5 every day. Begin Bible reading every day. Zero excuse. I'll be back tomorrow to give a little insight of what I see and talk about this thing called imitating God. Like, what does that even mean, to imitate God? I hope to see you back here again. Man, read the word. Zero excuse. Thank you for taking the challenge. Have a great Monday. Have a great week.